Here's the constellation question dealing with spacecraft travel time. There's a good chance you already know how to do this one, even if you don't know that you know it. You probably already have experience figuring out how long it takes to get places based on how fast you're traveling. In this question, we're doing the same thing, but the speeds and distances are much larger. Instead of figuring out how long it will take to drive to the beach, you'll be figuring out how long it takes a spacecraft to travel to a distant star. But mathematically, it's the same problem. Even if you find the calculation easy, please follow along to get used to the predict, calculate, and compare format we use in this class. We're going to follow the math worksheet and the steps covered on how to do word problems in the math online lectures. Remember that following these steps ensures that you've got all the information I'll be looking for in the assignment. The boxes labeled what you're trying to find and what you know are both the easiest and in some ways the most important parts of this worksheet. It's really the why are we doing this part of the question. For what you're trying to find, the easy answer is just the title of the question, the spacecraft travel time. This is often the case, but it's worth thinking a minute about what this actually means. The stars in your constellation are like our own sun, but much further away. Humans have sent robotic spacecraft to other planets orbiting our own sun, but we've never really tried to send a spacecraft to another star. In this question, we'll see why that is. So what we're trying to find is the time it takes a spacecraft to travel to distant stars. The what we know part is also based on what's in the question. Here is where you put in any important values that the question tells you that could help you solve the problem. There's one key thing you need to know, given in this question, the speed of the spacecraft. So you should write this number down, and don't forget to include the units. Next, we do the prediction. Remember that there are two parts to any prediction, what you predicted and why. The why is important because without that, it's not really a prediction. It's just a wild guess. The time it takes a spacecraft to travel from our sun to any given star will depend upon how far away from us that star is. So you should look at the distance column in your constellation table and decide which star should take the longest to travel to. You'll notice that only a few of the stars have distances listed, so you only need to worry about those stars. Later in the term, we'll figure out how to calculate the distances to the others. When you write down which star you expect, you should also say why you picked that star. Once you've done this, you've finished Part A of the assignment. Congratulations, you're already well into the problem, and you haven't even started calculating yet. The next two boxes will help us get ready to do the calculation. The first one is the equation we need to use to solve the problem. In this case, you've got that equation right in the question, so write it down here. T equals D divided by V. This means time equals distance divided by velocity. Since we're finding spacecraft travel times, we'll need to know how far the spacecraft is traveling and how fast it's going. The second box is where we put in the values we're going to use to solve the problem. We already know the velocity. We wrote that down earlier. So here we put in the distances. We already know where to find the distance. That's the distance column in your constellation table. So pick the three stars you'll be calculating and put their distances in here. In the next box, we're going to have to convert light years into kilometers. So here's a good point to look up how many kilometers there are in one light year. You can find this value in your textbook, in the online lecture on math, or simply look it up online. Also, at the end of the problem, we're going to have to convert the time from seconds to years, so it would also be good to look up the number of seconds in a year. Many students find this box the most challenging part of any calculation, so it's important to go through the steps we learned in the online lecture on math. First, we need to decide if a unit conversion is needed. Ask yourself, do all the mass units agree? Do all the distance units agree? Do all the time units agree? In this problem, we don't have any mass units, so we don't have to worry about that. But we do have time and distance units. The time comes up in the speed of the spacecraft. This tells us that the answer will have the same units as the time units in the speed. Since the speed is given in kilometers per second, the answer will be in seconds. Distance units appear in two places. One is in the distance itself, and the other is in the speed. Here is where we need to do a unit conversion, because the distance units don't match. The speed of the spacecraft has kilometers in it, while the distance is given in light years. Let's turn those light years into kilometers. To do that, we need a conversion factor, and that's why you wrote down the number of kilometers in a light year earlier. Remember that every conversion factor is a fraction, with the units that you're trying to get to on the top and the units you're getting away from on the bottom. So our conversion factor in this case will be 9.46 times 10 to the 12th kilometers per, or divided by, 1 light year. This will be easier to follow if we do an example. So let's look at a star that has a distance of 90 light years. We want to turn that into kilometers, so we multiply 90 light years by 9.46 times 10 to the 12th kilometers divided by 1 light year. We must cancel our units carefully to make sure that the right units come out in our answer. That gives us 8.51 times 10 to the 14th kilometers. Remember to stop and think about whether the answer makes sense. If it's many light years, it should be a bigger number than 1 light year. And that's what we're seeing here. The 10 to the 14th means this is a bigger number than 10 to the 12th, so the answer makes sense. Now we can actually calculate the time it takes for the spacecraft to travel. The first step is to rewrite the equation. This time, we put in the values for the distance and the velocity. Then we simply do what the equation tells us to do. Divide the distance by the velocity and get the time in seconds. Remember to be careful to put the exponents into your calculator the right way. Use the EE key or EXP key and don't put in extra times tens. In this case, the time came out to 1.89 times 10 to the 13 seconds. You probably don't have much idea of how long 10 to the 13 seconds is. I certainly don't. So we should convert that into the number of years so we can get a better sense of what this time really means. Here's where we use the number of seconds in a year, about 3.16 times 10 to the 7th, to make the conversion to years. Just make a fraction the same way as we did before, this time with the seconds on the bottom and the years on the top, since we want to get years as the answer. When we do this conversion, we get an answer that is about 6 times 10 to the 5 years, or 600,000 years. So it would take more than 500,000 years to travel to this star. With your own constellation, you should do this calculation for 3 different stars, including the one you predicted will have the longest travel time. Finally, check to see if your answers match your predictions. Did the right star have the longest travel time? There are 3 possibilities here. One is that everything matches up. In that case, you're done. Congratulations! Just write down that they match, so I know you did this step. Another possibility is that your calculations are fine, but your prediction was off. Don't just automatically assume this is the case if the answer disagrees. Make sure you understand why the answer is coming out the way it is. You should explain here what you should have said differently back in the prediction. But if you can now show that you understand what your prediction should have said, then you've got full credit on this problem anyways. You don't have to go back and change your prediction to get full credit on the question. The third possibility is that the answers don't agree, and the problem is with the math instead. Remember that the nearest stars are many orders of magnitude farther than the planets in our solar system, and it takes years to get to these planets. So if you're getting times that aren't thousands to millions of years, something is probably wrong with the calculation. If you're getting an answer that just doesn't look right, then you should go back and try redoing your calculations. Also, go through the example in this lecture and make sure you are agreeing with the answer we've got here. That will help you see if you're doing something wrong with the math. If you can't find the problem, you're always welcome to ask for help. Show us what you've done, and we'll be glad to help you get the question right. Most of the time when someone tries one of these calculations and gets a wrong answer, the mistake is really something very minor and easy to fix, so don't be afraid to ask when the numbers seem out of whack.